I can click here, adjust, and I will make its value as 5 ohm. Anyone has any doubt? Okay, so now my RL is also 5 ohm. Now I will just run this simulation. So right now I cannot run, so I must click somewhere, and then at the here we are having option run transient space. So I should click here. So the current through emitter is 1 ampere and RL is 5 ohm. So your power becomes current is 1 ampere, RL is 5 ohm. So power equal to I square into RL. So it is in the first case we get the power value as 5 watt. Okay. Now I should pause this simulation. Now I should use the case number 2. I should go for case number 2. For case number 2, I have to change the value of RL. In case number 2, RL is 2 ohm. So once again, I will make the change in my circuit by changing the value of RL. So now it is in yellow color. Once I click it, it becomes in yellow color. Then I should go to the adjust option and make its value as 2 ohm. Okay, now once again I should click somewhere and then run the simulation. Okay, the current value is 1.43. Current value is 1.43 ampere. RL is 2 ohm. Current is 1.43, RL is 2 ohm. So how much will be the power? I square into RL. So just see the case number 2. 1.43, 10 by 7 means 1.43. So power equal to I square into RL. So if you calculate it, it comes out as approximately 4 watt. So this is the power in case number 2. Now for case number 3, RL is now 15 ohm. RL value is 15 ohm. RL value is 15 ohm. So once again, I have to make that change in the circuit diagram. First, pause the simulation, click to the RL resistance, click here adjust and make its value 15 ohm. Okay, now it is 15 ohm. Now click somewhere and run the simulation. It will take some time. Okay, now the current value is 500 milliampere, that means 0.5 ampere, resistance is 15 ohm. Current is 500 milliampere, resistance is 15 ohm. Once again, I should calculate the power across this load. So current is 500 milliampere, that means 0.5 ampere. So power equal to I square into RL. So 0.5 square into resistance is 15 ohm. It comes out as 3.75 watt. So the conclusion is that whenever RL equal to RTH, we get the maximum power. So this is how you have to simulate this three circuit diagram. You have to take the screenshot of that three circuit diagram and you have to do the theoretical calculations also. So I will just talk about now write up. Clear hai, simple hai. Clear hai ye cheez, please reply in the chat box. Whether screen is visible? Yes. Vaibhav, please click on my photograph. You can see the screen. Okay. So I will just talk about write a very simple experiment. So you have to write down the aim. Regulated power supply, we are using 1. You can write the range also, resistance values, range you can write. Emitter, we are using 1 emitter, range will be dash dash dash, or you can put some range also. Then we will require some quantities of connecting wire. Then you have to write down the statement of maximum power transfer theorem. Then you have to write down the procedure. And you have to draw the circuit diagram 1. दिस इज अवर सर्किट डायग्राम वन, दिस इज अवर सर्किट डायग्राम वन. ओके, ऑन पे ऑन नोटबुक ओनली यू कैन ड्रॉ इट बाय हैंड. देन यू हैव टू राइट डाउन द थेरोटिकल कैलकुलेशन. सो हियर आर द थेरोटिकल कैलकुलेशन, हियर आर द थेरोटिकल कैलकुलेशन, दीज आर द थेरोटिकल कैलकुलेशन. ओके, एंड लास्ट केस इज यू हैव टू अटैच द स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ सिमुलेटेड सर्किट डायग्राम. सेम वे यू हैव टू ड्रॉ द सर्किट डायग्राम टू, यू हैव टू राइट डाउन द थेरोटिकल कैलकुलेशन टू. For circuit 2, you have to write down the theoretical calculations. You have to attach the screenshot of simulated circuit diagram. Similarly, circuit diagram 3, theoretical calculations and simulated circuit diagram. Observation table, what is the value of VTH? VTH is 10 volt. RTH 5 ohm. So, आपको यहाँ पे लिखना है. You have to write here. VTH 10 volt, RTH 5 ohm. Then, as we are having three cases, in first case, value of load resistance is 5, 2, and last case is 15. And you have to write down the power value. And your conclusion will be that whenever RTH equal to RL, we get the maximum power. So, this is about write-up. As well, you have to solve four numericals, which I have already given to you. So, you can take any four numericals, theoretical numericals, of maximum power. Okay, now the thing is that what you have to do, this is a sample thing, all these are the sample thing. You have to take by your own any VTH value, you have to take any RTH value, you have to take any RL value. Every student has to select its own VTH, own RTH and his own RL value. Then in second case, he will change the RL value. In third case also, he will change the RL value. So that everyone will do the different type of simulation. Is it clear? This is the sample thing. You have to do it your own. Please reply in the chat box whether you have understood what you have to do. Okay, thank you. So now we will move towards the second practical. Okay, some of you have joined late, so they can watch the video. I am doing the recording, so they can watch this video. So second, today one more practical I will explain. That is nothing but the simulation of RC circuit, simulation of RC circuit. Okay. Time response of RC circuit. So we will take this simple RC circuit. Okay, input resistance is 1 kilo ohm. And capacitor is 100 microfarad. If I take, instead of 100, if I take 10 microfarad, so what will be the change in the circuit diagram? What will be the change in the calculations? Instead of 100 microfarad, if I take 10 microfarad, time constant will be, okay, don't take, you will keep as it is. Instead of 100 microfarad, if I take here 50 microfarad, so what are the changes? Instead of 100 microfarad, if I take 50 microfarad, so now my time constant will be 0.05 seconds. Time constant will be 0.05 seconds. Whether it is correct? 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to minus 6, that means 50 into 10 raised to minus 3. 50 into 10 raised to minus 3. 15 to 10 raised to minus 3 is 0.05 seconds. So steady state I will get in. Steady state I will get in 5 into 0.05. That means 0.25. Okay. I will get steady state in 0.25 seconds. And my steady state voltage will be same 5 volt only. The value of steady state voltage will not change. So these are the changes if I change the value of capacitor. So I will try to simulate this circuit. I will try to simulate this circuit. So I have to take one. First, you should take DC voltage here and go to the adjust. Now you can here you can see the option of square wave. So click at the square wave. Now high should be 5 volt, 5 है कि 10 है? Okay, 5 volt. It should be high value should be 5 volt. So जैसे आप high पे क्लिक करेंगे यहाँ पे ये मीटर अवेलेबल आ जाएगा. The meter will be available. So rotate it in the clock anti clockwise direction and adjust it to 5 volt. Then period, we want the period as maximum period in this simulator we can get is the 1 second. The maximum period which we can get it in this simulator is 1 second. So I will adjust it to 1 second. That's why I change the capacitor value, because here is the limitation that the period of the waveform cannot be greater than 1 second. Now width 50%. Duty cycle means 50%. So I will adjust it to 50%. Then I don't want any rise time and fall time, so I will make it 0. This I will explain you what is rise time and fall time once we are having the waveforms. So I will first I should adjust rise time and fall time to 0%. Okay, so I have adjusted the input source. Now I should take one resistor value. I want to rotate it, so here is the rotate option. So just rotate it, then take one capacitor value. Okay. Now make the connections. Click on this node, click on this node, they get connected. Click at this node, click at this node, they get connected. Click at this node, click at this node, they get connected. Now what are the values of resistance and capacitor? Resistance is 1 kilo ohm, capacitor is 50 microfarad. Okay. So I should adjust resistance value as 1 kilo ohm. It is already there. And capacitor value, I should adjust it to 50 microfarad. So now it is in yellow color. I should click here, adjust. And adjust its value to the 50 microfarad. Okay. So this is how my circuit will look like. Simple circuit to build on every circuit app. Now next, what you have to do to see the output waveforms, to see the output waveforms, to see this type of waveforms, what you are supposed to do, you have to click here, okay, or you can you have to click here, and here you can see the show waveform option. It is an oscilloscope. Here you can see the show waveform option. So click here. Then you should click here. Then also you should click at the option show waveform. So now the important point. At the input side, it is in blue color. The waveform which I will get in the blue color is the input waveform. At the output side, it is in green color. The waveform which I will get in the green color will be my output waveform. Then I should run the transient response. To see the complete response, I should click run transient. Okay. So right now it is not showing properly. So what you have to do? You have to increase the simulation speed. At the bottom there is option simulation speed. So click here and increase the simulation speed. Okay. Then you can pause the waveform. So now you can see here by the waveform. Initially we are having charging of capacitor. This green color is the charging of capacitor. Then Here the steady state is reached. Constant means steady state is reached. Then now what is that? Discharging of capacitor. This one is the discharging of capacitor. Now capacitor is completely discharged. Again we will get the steady state. Once again we are having charging. Once again we are having discharging. So this is the output waveform similar to this thing. Okay, very simple. So this is how you have to observe this complete response. Now this blue color is nothing but my input voltage, square wave input voltage, 5 volt, then again 0, then 5 volt. When the input is 5 volt, when the input is 5 volt, I can see the charging of capacitor. When my input is 0 volt, I can see the discharging of capacitor. So this is the response which we have to observe. So if I click here, it gets minimized. Once again, if I click here, I can see the waveform. So very simple. I hope you can perform it in simulator. Easy to simulate? Yes or no? Please reply in the chat box. If you get any difficulty, definitely video is available. Please reply in the chat box. Is it easy to simulate? Or shall I explain it once again? Easy to simulate, very easy to simulate. Okay. So, for one more circuit, I will explain you how to do the simulation so that you will get familiar. And you also visualize what we have to do next, what we have to do next. See, I am getting perfect because of doing practice. So, you will also face some difficulty initially. That because I got the output in, I think, less than 10 minutes while explaining. So you may also get some time, but once you get familiar, it becomes easier. So now what I will do, I will take this circuit. This is the circuit diagram. Okay. But I don't want tau should be 0.5 seconds. So I will take here 1 millifarad. I will take the capacitor value as 1 millifarad. So now what will be the change? 50 × 10⁻³. The time constant will be 0.05 seconds. Phi tau will be 0.05 × 5. That means 0.25 seconds. Okay. And steady state capacitor voltage will be 5 volt only, not 10 volt. Because of, I hope you can determine the steady state voltage. So open the capacitor. Open the capacitor, input is 10 volt, that will get divided in 100 ohm resistor as 5 volt and in 100 ohm resistor as 5 volt by using voltage division rule. As this resistance and capacitor are in parallel, so capacitor steady state voltage will be, in steady state capacitor voltage will be 5 volt. If someone has some any difficulty, they can watch the video of RC circuits. Capacitor steady state voltage will be 5 volt. ओके सिंपल. तो अब जब मैं आउटपुट वेवफॉर्म देखूंगा तो मुझे आउट कैपेसिटर का वोल्टेज 5 वोल्ट दिखना चाहिए, ना कि 10 वोल्ट. इनपुट 10 वोल्ट है, इनपुट इज 10 वोल्ट, बट आई शुड सी द आउटपुट वोल्टेज एज 5 वोल्ट ओनली, एज वेल एज आई शुड सी द चार्जिंग एंड डिस्चार्जिंग ऑफ कैपेसिटर लाइक दिस. दिस टाइप ऑफ वेवफॉर्म आई शुड ऑब्जर्व थ्रू सिमुलेटर. ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट डिलीट दिस कंप्लीट सर्किट. From beginning I will start. Okay, so I should take one voltage source. Then three resistances. Sorry, two resistances. I want to rotate this resistance. So rotate option is available at the bottom. Then one more resistance. And I should take one capacitor. Okay. So input voltage is 10 volt. So now it is in yellow color. I should click at the adjust option. And rotate it clockwise so that input becomes 10 volt. Okay. Now I should set this as square wave type input signal, not DC signal, complete DC signal. I should take it as square wave. So click at the square wave and adjust its value to the 10 volt. Okay. Period, I should take 1 second. So rotate it in the clockwise direction. Okay, period is 1 second. Width should be 50%. Duty cycle is 50%. I don't want any rise time. So I will make it zero. I don't want any fall time. So I will make it zero. Okay, so input is adjusted. Now what is the value of R and C? R is 100 ohm. R is 100 ohm. C is 1 millifarad. So R is 100 ohm. So rotate it in the anti-clockwise direction. Make it 100 ohm. This also. अभी येलो कलर में वैल्यू चेंज कर सकते 100 ओम कैपेसिटर 1 मिली फैरेड ओके कैपेसिटर इज 1 मिली फैरेड नाउ मेक द कनेक्शन क्लिक हियर इट गेट्स कनेक्टेड क्लिक हियर इट गेट्स कनेक्टेड क्लिक हियर इट गेट्स कनेक्टेड क्लिक टू द नोड्स गेट्स कनेक्टेड Okay. Now I want to see the input side, waveform of input side, and click on the show waveform. It is in blue color. Now I will click here. Again, click on show waveform. Okay. And just run it. Now, as waveform is not coming properly, so I should adjust the simulation speed. I should adjust the simulation speed. Okay. Then I will just make it pause. If I don't take rise time and fall time as zero, so what I will get, I will not get perfect square wave. Even though I have taken it as 0%, still some, I think there is some tilt in the square wave. Okay. If I select it is 1%, 10%, then definitely my square wave will not be perfect. It will have some tilt. Agar main rise time, this is the perfect square wave. If I take 10% rise times, and then what will happen? I will get some tilt. If I take 10% fall time, then I will get the tilt. But I want perfect square wave, that's why I have taken rise time fall time as 0%. Okay, so this is the simulated waveform. Green color is what? Output, how much is the value here? How much is the value here? Here 5 volt. This blue color is the input. Input is 10 volt. Theoretically also we got this type of waveform. 5 volt the charge ho raha, fir constant steady state. Then after that, once input is zero, capacitor is discharging. Okay. Simple, clear. If it is clear, reply in the chat box with C so that I will also come to know. Yes, very good question. Abhi itna important point chal raha hamara aur inko attendance ka pad raha. Yes, Gayatri, you can left the meeting and mark your attendance. I don't mind. Yes. If it is clear, reply in the chat box with C. Okay. I want reply from other students also. If it is clear, reply in chat box with C. ओके हाँ सर, कैन यू प्लीज टेल हाउ टू कन्वर्ट वोल्ट मीटर इनटू ऑसिलोस्कोप? ऑसिलोस्कोप इज यूज टू ऑब्जर्व द वेव फॉर्म्स। ऑसिलोस्कोप इज यूज टू ऑब्जर्व द वेव फॉर्म एंड वोल्ट मीटर विल डायरेक्टली गिव यू द डिजिटल रीडिंग्स। वी यूज ऑसिलोस्कोप टू ऑब्जर्व द वेव फॉर्म एंड फ्रॉम वेव फॉर्म वी मेजर द वोल्टेज। फ्रॉम ऑसिलोस्कोप वी ऑब्जर्व द वेव फॉर्म एंड वी मेजर द वोल्टेज, बट इन वोल्ट मीटर डू वी डायरेक्टली गेट द वोल्टेज रीडिंग। तो हाउ टू कन्वर्ट वोल्ट मीटर इंटू ऑसिलोस्कोप? वी कैन नॉट कन्वर्ट वोल्ट मीटर इंटू ऑसिलोस्कोप। ऑसिलोस्कोप इज यूज टू ऑब्जर्व द वेव फॉर्म्स एंड वोल्ट मीटर विल जस्ट गिव यू द वोल्टेज रीडिंग। ओके, नाउ अबाउट राइट अप। तो एम यू कैन राइट, इट इज अवेलेबल। देन रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाई, यू आर यूजिंग वन रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाई। रेजिस्टेंसेज, रेंज क्वांटिटी, कैपेसिटर रेंज क्वांटिटी। ऑसिलोस्कोप, यू आर यूजिंग टू ऑसिलोस्कोप। रेंज इफ यू कीप डैश, नो प्रॉब्लम। देन इन द वन ऑफ द वीडियो आई हैव डिराइव्ड द डिस्चार्जिंग इक्वेशन ऑफ सोर्स फ्री आरसी सर्किट। So that thing you have to write here. You have to write down that derivation. For a source free RC circuit, we have derived that equation. V of t equal to V naught bracket V of t equal to V naught e raised to power minus t by tau. That expression we have derived. That expression you have to derive here. Okay. Then procedure also you can write. Then as I have simulated two circuit diagrams, so you can also you can draw the circuit diagram first. You can write down these theoretical calculations. You can write down these theoretical calculations. Okay, these are the theoretical calculations. This is the circuit diagram. Then next, what you have to do it in the write up. You have to draw the simulated circuit diagram. That means you have to take the screenshot of this circuit diagram. Here is one option available to take the screenshot. To save the screenshot, I think you have already done it, right? Then next, what one more thing you have to attach in your write-up, that is nothing but the simulated waveforms. Okay, and whenever you are writing down theoretical calculations, you should draw waveforms also. आपको waveforms भी draw करना है जब आप theoretical calculations लिखेंगे. Now at the end, you have to draw the you have to attach the screenshot of simulated waveform. Then input voltage, how much input voltage you have taken? 10 volt. Then the time period of input voltage. Time period of input voltage 1 second. Here it is written 1 second. Okay, that you can write. Then steady state voltage. That means in this case the steady state voltage is 5 volt. Green color. Steady state voltage is 5 volt. That you have to write down. As well, you have to write down the value of time constant. That's it. The same thing you have to repeat it for one more circuit diagram. Same thing you have to repeat it for one more circuit diagram. Okay. Then you can solve any two numericals based on RC circuit. By I have taken so many numerical, so you can take any two numerical from homework or somewhere, and you can write down. Okay. क्लियर? राइट अप लिखना कुछ डिफिकल्टी? वी हैव टू सिमुलेट द सेम सर्किट. ओके, दैट आल्सो आई विल टेल. हाँ, एनी अदर डिफिकल्टी व्हाइल राइटिंग द राइट अप? ओके, नाउ स्टूडेंट हैव आस्क सम डाउट. वी हैव टू सिमुलेट द सेम सर्किट. सो इट्स अप टू यू. आई विल गिव यू द चॉइस. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू शो दैट सर वी हैव अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग, वी हैव, बिकॉज वॉट विल हैपन इफ एवरी स्टूडेंट इज इम्प्लीमेंटिंग इज ओन सर्किट, देन डेफिनेटली ही विल गेट प्रॉब्लम विद द टाइम पीरियड. उसको प्रॉब्लम आएगा टाइम पीरियड में, ओके, बिकॉज ही विल टेक एनी वैल्यूज ऑफ आर सी, देन टाइम कॉन्स्टेंट विल बी सम डिफरेंट वैल्यू एंड हिज टाइम पीरियड विल बी सम डिफरेंट वैल्यू. हाउ टू टेक द टाइम पीरियड वैल्यू, दैट प्रॉब्लम ही विल फेस. सो इट्स अप टू यू, इफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड इट थॉरली, यू कैन टेक यूर ओन सर्किट, यू कैन टेक यूर ओन टाइम पीरियड. आई एक्सपेक्ट दैट एटलीस्ट 20 स्टूडेंट्स विल सिमुलेट डिफरेंट सर्किट्स रैदर देन कॉपिंग दिस सेम सर्किट. I expect 20 students will simulate different circuits. For rest students, it's up to them. They can simulate this circuit or they can simulate by their own. If you simulate your own circuit, that means you are doing some mental work, and it will be good. And I will definitely give some weightage also while giving the marks. Okay. Now one more student has raised the question that I have taken time period as 1 second. It's because of the time constant value. Now your time constant value in the second case is 0.25 seconds. In first case it is again steady state time is 0.25 seconds. So as to observe this thing, so as to observe the complete charging, this is the transient response. ये जो increase हो रहा ना exponential charging, 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 capacitor की charging. So this is the transient response. Then this is the steady state. जब वो constant हो जाता, that is the steady state. ठीक है? Now as you are, in the last lecture also I told you that you should take the value of time period such that you can observe transient response also, as well as you can observe steady state also. Okay? चलो. Suppose instead of 1 second. I will take it 0.8 second. So what will happen? Instead of 1 second, if I take it 0.8 second, that means 800 milliseconds. So what will be the change? Okay. You should select the time period such that you can observe transient as well as steady state. चलो अभी 800 milliseconds लिया, time period अब run करते. Okay. So there is little bit change here. Instead of 800 millisecond, let us say if I take it as 600 millisecond, run. So again, there is some little small change in the charging time of capacitor. Instead of 600 millisecond, let us say I will take it as 400 millisecond. Run it. Okay. Now I will just make a pause. तो आपको क्या दिखा कि आपका जो steady state में duration आपको कम दिख रहा? That is the observation by changing the time period. Here the steady state is just reach. And just we are getting small duration for steady state. That is the only change. No problem if you don't take exact 1 second. I don't mind. But you should observe charging of capacitor, then some small duration steady state, then discharging, then again steady state. ऐसी चीज़ आपको